Hello guys, welcome to my channel and welcome to M4 Maths, and I'm Sanjeevan Ghosh with you. And after a long period of time, we're meeting again each other. And first of all, I want to ask you that how are you all? I hope that you are doing well. And as we all know that today is Valentine's Day, so I will show you one equation by which you can just wish your partner and in the mathematical language. But one thing I want to clarify, that after that, if you broke up, then I will not be responsible. Okay, so without any kind of wasting of time, let us start with that equation. So guys, I will write here one equation and I will do that sum, and whatever the answer will come, that will be the main thing for today. Okay, so before starting that one, I will like to tell you that to understand this one, you just need to know very simple mathematics such as differentiation, integration, and one equation from physics, and little bit complex number. Though if you don't know all these things, no need to worry about that. I will tell all of the things while I will be writing these things. So without wasting, so let us write that equation. Okay, so first of all, I'm writing here one equation, p squared by s into ddp log of a into log of p to the power h, then plus minus a square n square whole over root by n, sorry, a square n square by n into log of e to the power n plus 1 into d dy into t log y to the power l, that is equals to a s to the power minus 1 by p integration 0 to small d d of dt. Right, here I want to tell that here only p, y and d, capital D, I'm taking them as variable, and all the other things that I have written here, those are constant, I am treating them as. Okay, so now let us do imply it is becoming p squared by s. Now whenever we are differentiating, we know that whenever any constant is in front of the differentiation, that comes outside of the differentiation, because differentiation does not affect that constant if any function is multiplied with any constant. So for that one, this constant a will come outside and in front of this differentiation. So we are getting this. Then ddp log of p to the power h. Okay. Now here we are getting root over of minus 1, and a square is coming outside of the root, so it will be capital A, and so on for the n. And in the below, it was m. Okay. Here I want to tell that this for m, I am taking this one as a mass of any kind of object. Okay. Now, for the, logarithm, in class 10, you have learned about this one. If anything is there, whatever that number is given beside log, if there is any kind of power given to it, that power comes in front of that log, right? So here we can see it is e to the power n plus 1, that power e to the power n plus 1 will come in front of that log, and here we will get log e, right? This is very easy. I'm telling that equation whenever you are getting like this one, log of a to the power m, that constant or whatever the power is given, that come in front of it, and we get log of a only. So like that one, we are also getting this thing here also too. Okay. Now let us go to the next. Now this one, this t again constant, and for just like this one, a came in front of that derivative. This t will come also outside of the derivative, and we will get d dy log of y to the power a. And I am not doing anything on the right hand side, I will do later. So I am just copying this one up. A is to the power minus 1 by p, integration 0 to d into dt. Inside of it, dt. Okay. Now let us come here. P square by s into a ddp. Just I have already told you, any power given to any number given after log, that will come in front of that log. So it is becoming h log p. And from the complex number, we know that root over of minus 1 is a complex number, and it is being denoted by iota, that is small I. So I am writing in the complex number, we know that I square equals to minus 1. I hope that you know it well if you are a science student. If you are not, then also no problem. I have just already told you. So I hope it is clear to you. Now A is remaining as it was, N is remaining, and here it is M. Now from the laws of indices, in class 9 you have learned this one, or any class you have learned this one, so we know whenever we are getting A to the power M plus N, that means if you are getting any addition in the power, that will become multiplication. That means you can write this one as A to the power M into A to the power N. Whenever the bases are same, so whenever we are multiplying, the powers got added up, and vice versa. If powers is given as adding up something, so we can write them up by product of two different things. So with this equation, we can write this one as e to the power n into e to the power 1, right? And we know from the standard base, any base is not written over log, then it will be treated as base e. And we know when the base and that thing becomes equal, then the value of log gives us 1. So that for that reason, log e will also gives us 1, because no base is written there, so we will treat that as e only, right? So we are getting here 1, and then t, let it be at it, as it was, then d dy. Same for reason, l is coming in front of log and we are getting log y. And here inside of it, we are getting a is equal minus 1 by p. And we know whenever we are integrating anything like this one dx, then answer will come only x, right? So if we differentiate dd, the answer will come only d. And since it is a definite integral, so we have to put those limits 0 to d. Right. Now, let us come to the next. I hope that you cannot see, so I am just rubbing up the previous two lines. Okay, I am not rubbing up the last line so that you can recognize from here. Right, after that, if I write here, you cannot be able to see the board. Anyways. Okay, so let us see what it is coming. So we are getting e squared by s into a. Now h is a constant is coming in front of it, and we are getting d dp of log p only plus I a n by m e to the power n into e to the power 1 into t. E to the power 1 you may not write that one, no problem. This l again coming in front of the derivation, and you are getting d dy of log y, right? Now on the right hand side, let us see what we are getting actually. A is to the power minus 1 by p into, if we put the limits, first of all what we have to do, we have to put the upper limit, then minus, then lower limit. I'm telling you, this is the variable. So in place of the variable, we have to put the upper limit first. That means we are putting d in place of capital D. Minus, in the place of variable d, we have to put the lower limit, whatever is given, lower side of this third bracket. That is minus 0, right? So we will do, I will do this same thing here. It is becoming d minus 0, right? Okay, so now let us go to the next. I'm just rubbing up the board again because we will not be able to see otherwise. Okay, now the next line, let us see what it is coming. E squared by s into a into h. And we know whenever we are differentiating anything of log, it gives us 1 by x. Suppose we are differentiating d dx of log x, the answer will come 1 by x. This is a formula, okay? In class 11, 12, I hope that you have seen it. Okay. Then also, I am just writing the formula. If you don't know, no problem. D dx of log x, that means if we derivative log of any variable, then the answer does come is 1 by x. By using this one, here also we will get 1 by p. Because the variable was p and it was given log p. Nothing else, just x has been replaced with a p only. Okay. So, you are all are intelligent. You are understanding, I think so. Anyways. Okay, now the next one. It is giving you I a n by m. E to the power n into only e I am writing. Because if the power is 1, we may not write that one. Into t into l, and as you know, as I have done here 1 by p, it will also be 1 by y. I have chosen the same so that you don't have to be very much confused, because some of you
may not know the derivative, may not know the integration. So I am not using very much harder things here. Okay.
Now here a is to the power minus 1 by p and into d. Because we know if we subtract 0, that doesn't matter anything. 1 minus 0 will give you 1, 2 minus 0 will give you 2, and so on. D minus 0 will give you b. Okay. Now let us come here. Now most of you are thinking that we may cut p and p. Yes, we can cut out p and p, but I will not do so. I will take the LCM of this p and I will make it go that side. Okay, so if we do so, then you are getting here HAP square by S plus IAM into P by M. This P, I am just multiplying this P with this one and I will multiply here also. Okay, P by M, E to the power N into E into T into L by Y equals to A is to the power minus 1 by P into D into P. Okay. Now here P and P getting cancelled out. Very good. Now see what I am doing. We know from the physics, you know that momentum is generally being denoted by small p. And what does it mean by momentum? Momentum is nothing but whenever we are multiplying velocity of a body with the mass of that body, then whatever we are getting, that is called the momentum, right? And that means, suppose v is the velocity of any kind of object and m be the mass, then we can write p, that means momentum, is equals to m into v. And from that one we can get that p divided by m is giving you v only, that means the velocity of that body. I hope that you are understanding. In the place of p by m, I will put v. From this is the physics that I have already told you. I will use a little bit of physics also here. Okay. So from here, in the place of p by m, I will write v. Okay, so keep on watching. Okay, so let it be as it was HAP squared by S plus IAN, and this is I'm writing V into E to the power N into E into T into L by Y equals to DAS to the power minus 1. Okay, very good. Now what I will do, I will multiply all of the terms with y. Basically, I am doing the LCM of y. Okay, no problem. Just see, keep on watching. Again, I am rubbing up the previous lines. Okay. I hope it will be easier to see for you also. Anyways. Okay. Now I am just multiplying each of the term by y, then what I am getting, let's see, HAP square into y by S plus IANV e to the power n e into t into L by y into y, and also we have to multiply right hand side also, because whenever we are multiplying or dividing anything in case of equation, we have to do the same thing with both of the hands, I mean left hand side also, right hand side also, and with each of the terms also too, which are consisting in the left hand side or in the right hand side also. So here we are getting DAS to the power minus 1 into y. Okay, so here y and y is getting cancelled out. Right, so all of the things are almost done. One thing that you are understanding that here it is S, so we will not put here. So again in the second line, I will multiply both, I mean all of the terms with S only. And then I hope that I will get the answer. Same what I am doing. Again we are multiplying each of the line, I mean each of the parts with S. HAP square into Y by S into S. I am writing the V first, because in case of multiplication, we can change all of the numbers, because multiplication do follow the commutative law, right? Because you know that 2 into 3, 3 2's are is also 6, 2 3's are also 6. And that means 3 into 2 will give you 6 and 2 into 3 also give you 6. So if we change the order in multiplication, that does not bother the answer. So V, then I am putting A, then I am putting L, then I am putting E to the power N, then I am putting T, then I am putting I, then I am putting this N, then I am putting this E. Okay, I hope that all are done. Let us see. V, A, L, E to the power N, T, I, N, E. All I have written, I have not skipped a single thing. Right. Now I am multiplying by S, so I am putting here S, And here dA is to the power minus 1 into y into s. So only a few lines are left. Here you are getting HA. P square, you can write P into P by the laws of indices. And then y, s and s is getting cancelled out. And here you are getting V A L e to the power n T I N E S D A H to the power minus 1 plus 1, because you know by laws of indices, whenever we are multiplying two numbers and the same numbers, power get added up. Here the power is given minus 1. Here nothing is written, so we have to treat the power as 1. So it is becoming minus 1 plus 1. Right? And y. Only few more lines. Into y. V A L e to the power n T I N E S D A S to the power 0 into y. And we know anything to the power 0 gives you 1 until and unless it is becoming 0 to the power 0. And I'm treating that s is not equals to 0, though I should tell this at the beginning. I'm sorry for that. I'm telling right now s, I'm taking such a constant which is not 0. Okay. So we can write like this one, H A P P Y plus V A L E N T I N E S D A Y. Since h to the power 0 equals to 1, and we may write 1, we may not write 1. So this is the answer, but it is coming. Happy Valentine's Day. So this is how you can give that equation, previous equation that I have already told you, towards your partner. And you may tell them to solve it out, and answer will obviously surprise them. So another one thing I'm telling you, if after that one, if you broke up, then I will not be responsible. Thank you friends for watching this video. Keep supporting me. And if you're new to this channel, then you can do subscribe this channel also too. And do share this video with your Valentine also. Thank you. Be well, stay well, and stay connected.